Let us talk about ports. A port serves as an interface between the computer and other computer or peripheral devices. They can be classified as male and female ports, where the male port goes inside a female port, or we can classify them as serial ports and parallel ports, where serial ports send and receive one bit at a time via a single wire pair, whereas parallel ports receive multiple bits sent over multiple wires at a time. Now we also need to know the types of data transmission. Data transfer can be synchronous, where a sender and receiver take some time to agree upon the parameters of data exchange and then the communication starts. It can also be asynchronous, where the sender sends each burst with the parameter information, hence more error occurs, but it is also faster. It does not require any local storage at the terminals. And synchronous data transfer is made possible by handshaking. After ports are connected, they require handshaking, where transfer type, transfer rate, and other necessary information is shared before the data is sent. Now let us look at some of the common ports in use. We start with the DVI or Digital Visual Interface, and it connects monitors and DVD players. Next we have the display ports, and it is used to connect monitors and audio devices in most Apple products. Afterwards, we have the eSATA, and it connects hard drives. We have the PS2 for keyboards and mouse and PC, and it is considered a legacy port. That is, it is considered to be partially or fully superseded, in this case by the USB. We also have the VGA port, or the video graphics array, used to connect monitors. It is now also becoming a legacy port. And finally, we have the HDMI, or the High Definition Multimedia Interface, which transfers uncompressed video data from a display controller like a set-top box to a monitor or television.